The smoking room was filled with a cloud of cigarette smoke. The expensive smoke filter gave off some crackling electric noise, but it didn't seem like it was doing anything at all. Why do smokers have to be shoved so far down this corridor where the sun didn't even reach? I recalled hearing that the tax revenue from tobacco is about a tenth of the revenue. We were the most heavily taxed members of this municipality there. So I really wished they'd show us a little more respect. Wait, is that Kuma? One of the younger detectives was having a staring contest with the Mahjong magazine called Next Turn.
Uman 切っても天杯崩れませんから。背底にかけるなら両面で受けた方がチャンスあるんじゃないですか?
クマちゃん、川を見てください。
Holy shit! Kuma looks a lot different than the anime version, damn!
ウーマンは全員切ってますから、安牌なんですよ。終盤で K 店に走った誰かがダマで待ってたら嫌でしょ?
The kid let out another groan, put out his cigarette, then took out another one.
納得いかないっすね。わざわざ自分で当たり牌減らすなんて。
ちなみに、背底で当たり牌出しても論しちゃダメですよ。
え?どうしてですか?
Just then, I heard a voice coming from down the hall.
おいさん、いますか?一般の方から凱旋です。
ありゃ、こりゃどうも。それじゃ、ちょいと失礼。
どうして論しちゃダメなんすか?ああ、待ってくださいよ、大石さん!
Damn, someone really likes their mahjong. The man sitting in the seat Oishi-san was heading towards waved at the telephone receiver.
外線です。講習から。
ああ、どうもすいません。お待たせしました。大石です。もしもし?
お、大石さんですか?もしもし?
前原さんじゃありませんか。どうもどうも、こんにちは。
From the tone my Barakun's voice, from the tone my Barakun's voice, I think there's a missing word in there. From the tone of my Barakun's voice, I already knew he was in a predicament. This was the first time my Barakun had phoned me. Oh my god, we're seeing this from Oishi's perspective. That's kind of badass. And he was calling me. Can we have a whole, like, Oishi spin-off Higurashi show? Like, seriously? I love that dude so much. He's like exactly what I love about those old school detective shows. I want his own damn show.
落ち着いてください。何がありました?
His voice was erratic over the line. He had completely lost his sense of composure. After checking that nobody else could hear, I prompted him in a hushed tone.
何があったんです?
俺
落ち着いて前原さん今そこに近場の警官を行かせます私もすぐそっちに行きますよ
その多分無理です
His voice was quivering and hoarse He wasn't surrounded by people even as he was making this call, was he?
前原さんは今公衆電話からかけてますよねどこの公衆電話ですか?
There were no other sounds beside my broken voice. It had to be a phone booth. I scratched out a note and thrust it at my colleague sitting across from me. Hinamizawa, phone booth. He understood quickly and hastily started on the internal lines.
落ち着いて、前原さん。今、どういう状況なんです?
It was best practice to avoid flustering someone panicking, but this was an urgent case. My Barokun didn't just get in trouble, get away, and then call me. He was in the midst of something dangerous right now. But yelling at my Barokun right now would just needlessly cause him to be even more frantic. My Barokun wasn't just calling to seek help. He was trying to tell us something more than that. And whatever that was, fucking Oishi's like way more brain than I am, apparently. I can't read any of his goddamn lines. If I didn't get it from this call, I was certain there would never be another chance. My colleague pushed a note in front of me. There's only one phone booth in Hinamizawa. A patrol car is on the way. 5 minutes.
かかりすぎです。警らには何人乗ってます?
2人です。
Not enough. If it was as I imagined, there were likely quite a few people surrounding my Barokun. 5 minutes was too long.
南沢の駐在さんには電話しました。定時巡回の時間です。家人は留守で連絡不能。そう。クマちゃん、車を回してください。
了解っす!
Oh, this is cool.
もしもし、大丈夫です。ちゃんと聞こえてますよ。
There was something wrong with my Barokun. That wasn't a normal coughing sound. Vomiting? Or was it... blood? Had he already been attacked? Was he injured?
前原さん、今そこに警官が向かってます。2、3分で到着しますから何とか持ちこたえてください。 もしもし、聞こえてますか? 前原さん。
I could hear on the other end of the line that he was having a coughing fit. The worst possible situation popped into my head.
前原さん! 犯人は誰です? 何人なんです?
俺も… 最初は人間が犯人なんだと思い…
I couldn't tell if it was a cough or vomiting.
大丈夫ですか? 前原さん!
犯人は人間なんだって。お社様のたたりなんかないんだって。ついさっきまで。だけど、やっぱり…
It was an intense bout of coughing, then vomiting.
やっぱり、お社様ってのは、います。
前原さん、どうか、どうか落ち着いて。なんかさっきから、おかしいと思ってたんです。ずっとつけてくるんですよ。走っても走っても、影みたいにぴったりくっついて。だけど、少しずつ、少しずつ、
俺の背中にいじり寄ってくるんです。前原さん、そいつは今ひょっとして前原さんの後ろに。後ろに、すぐ後ろに。お願いです、前原さん。怖いのはわかります。ですが、お願いです。あなたの後ろに誰がいるんです。振り向けるわけ。
ないじゃないですか。振り向いたら、俺、怖いのはわかります。でも教えてほしい。ちょっと振り返るだけでいいんです。前原さんの後ろに誰がいるんです。
Right after I said that, I could hear him vomiting intensely. What followed was a nightmarish sound.
前原さん。 あんたまさか喉を引っかいてたりはしないでしょうね?
There was no answer, but I could hear something like scratching. There was a bang, as if something was being hit. My Barokun had probably dropped the receiver. I could hear groaning and vomiting over on the other end, and a repeating abnormal noise.
もしもし! もしもし! 前原さん! もしもし!
I knew how far away my voice would sound on the other end, but I couldn't help but shout. At that moment, I heard whispering coming from the other end. I couldn't tell what he was saying. From the way he was saying it, was he talking to himself? Or was he talking to someone there?
もしもし、前原さん?
Rather than whispering, it was some kind of mantra he was chanting over and over. I focused my senses, trying to pick up what he was saying. What was he repeating? What exactly? Was he saying, I'm sorry, over and over again? Suddenly, the line went dead. Did he use up his time? It was because it was a payphone. It was because it cut out so abruptly. The last thing he said came out so clearly in my mind.
Oi-san! Kuruma wa oke su! Oi-san!
Gomen nasai, da.
Oi-san?
That was badass. I love that. That's what he was repeating over and over. He said, I'm sorry. I had a gut feeling. There was no longer a need to hurry. I could hear the chirp of the Higurashi spilling in from the open window. I should have been able to hear them this entire time. I just wasn't paying any attention. Why did I focus on them all of a sudden? Were they trying to tell me something? Only the Higurashi knew. That's how I felt. June, 1983. In Hinamizawa, a remote village near Shishibone City, there was a murder involving two female students. The suspect is Keiichi Maibara, aged something teens. The suspect called over his two female classmates, Rena and Mion Sonozaki, to his house and beat them to death with a metal bat. The scene of the crime was the suspect's room on the second floor of his house. The inside of the room was covered with a significant quantity of splattered blood, and there were signs of a struggle with the victims. In addition to the scene of the crime, the entryway, living room, and kitchen all had traces of a struggle. At the entryway, the shoe rack and wall had evidence of being impacted by a strong blunt force. It is believed to have been the same bat as the murder weapon. Having no traces of blood, it is believed the destruction occurred before the murders. There is the possibility that the suspect overpowered his victims to keep them from fleeing. In the living room, the rug had been pulled back, then thrown aside. It is hard to believe that this had a connection to the struggle with the victims, and thus the reason for this remains unknown. In the kitchen, the garbage bag was torn apart and its contents were spread out on the floor. Garbage was strewn about in the surrounding area, and handprints believed to belong to the suspect were discovered. It is believed that the suspect had, for some reason, taken out the garbage and struck it with his fists. The reason for this remains unknown. In addition, there was a note stuck to the fridge. The words, "Was there a needle?" were written on it. The meaning behind this remains unclear. Just in case, the garbage was searched, but a needle was not discovered. Though the garage door was functional, it had been left open ever since the suspect moved in. The garage door was found closed. The suspect's fingerprints were discovered on the garage door. The reason behind this remains unknown. The suspect fled the scene of the crime. However, a patrolling officer, Hinamizawa Local PD, found... What the fuck? They've got a police department? I guess they do. Sonozaki's own it, I guess. Found the suspect collapsed inside a phone booth. At the time of discovery, the suspect was unconscious in critical condition. He was rushed to the local hospital for treatment, but did not regain consciousness and died 24 hours later. What the fuck? The results of the autopsy indicate the immediate cause of death to have been hypovolemic shock. It was determined that the suspect had clotted his own throat with his fingernails, and the resulting bleeding caused his death. With the similarity to the death of Tomotake-san the prior week, the police believe that there is a connection and have opened an investigation. However, due to the wishes of the local authorities, it will be a confidential investigation. Due to the abnormal nature of the death, it was suspected that drugs were involved, but as with Tomotake-san, no traces were discovered. What prompted all this remains inexplicable. As such, this case is being treated as an act committed on impulse. However, with several accounts of the suspect's bizarre behavior leading up to the incident, it is possible that this was premeditated. Separated from his group of friends, isolation, inexplicable behavior, several days before the incident, the suspect began carrying around a metal bat. The suspect was observed displaying aggressive behavior as well as talking to himself at school. His classmates have actually heard portions of what he was saying. 2 days before the incident, the suspect declared to his parents the possibility of his death. Due to these circumstances, my stomach is making a very loud noise. Due to these circumstances, the police had begun an investigation on the possibility that this crime was not committed on impulse, but was instead planned several days in advance. Afterwards, a note was found in the suspect's room that he had written himself. The note was written on two sheets from a B5 college-ruled notebook that had each been torn in half. And as if trying to conceal it, it was stuck hidden behind a clock on the wall. The contents are as written in the appendix. The police believe it to be as strongly related to the incident. The police changed their line of investigation based on the possibility that the suspect was involved in some sort of incident himself. However, no further clues were found, casting doubt on the credibility of the note. Was the crime impulse or premeditated? With the situation unclear and no further developments, the case has been labeled as unresolved. What about the syringe? However, the following year, suspicion arose regarding the nature of the note. The note was not written on two halves of B5 paper from two separate sheets, but was originally a single sheet of B5 paper. In order to erase several lines from the middle, someone had torn them out. Judging from the size of the letters, the missing section is estimated to be 2 to 3 lines. It is highly probable that the person who eliminated the lines in question is not the suspect. In addition, judging from traces of large quantities of cellophane tape being stuck to the back of the clock, speculation that something other than the note was stuck there has arisen. The person who first discovered the crime was a detective rumored to have been had a connection with the incident. That's his full name. Oishi. Okay. I don't know how to pronounce his first name, but he underwent voluntary questioning, but denies involvement in any damages to the note. The suspect's note: I, Keiichi Maibara, am in fear of my life. I do not know why they are after my life. The only thing I do know is that it has to do with Oyashiro-sama's curse. Rena and Mion are conspirators of the perpetrators. There are 4 or 5 adults, maybe more. They have a white van. This is all on the first sheet. The section below this has been ripped out. This is from the second sheet. The section above this has been ripped out. I have no idea why it has become like this. If you are reading this, then I am probably already dead. Though you may or may not find my body, you who are reading this, please uncover the truth. That is my only desire. Keiichi Maibara. What? A new scene has been unlocked. All cast review session has become available. To play it, go to the extra, pick the all cast review session. Oh, we're just at Angelmort now, okay. Oh my god, we're done? Please uncover the truth. Achievement unlocked. Well, but I also just realized that the red lines on each chapter for this are the same that you have on the manga, too. I guess they kept that theme when they published the manga. Oh my god, okay, it's over? What the fuck? I mean, sure, I knew that it was going to be over, but you can't end it like that. Let's go to extra and see. All cast review session. Let's see, what is this? Is this like all of the cast just talking about their shit?
Hi, Higurashi no Naku Koro ni Sui, Onikakushi o play sareta minasan, otsukare sama deshita.
You're very welcome, Rena.
Ikaga datta deshou ka?
It was amazing.
Choppiri demo tanoshinde moraetara, tottemo ureshii desu.
ちょっぴりも何もあんなすごいバッドエンドで終わられたらプンプンでございますことよ。
It didn't make me angry. I was so fucking entranced when I saw that first ending. And I was like, where the hell is the rest of this anime gonna go? And then I watched the next episode and my brain went smooth. It just melted. That's what I fucking love about this. And the visual novel is gonna be the same damn thing, except with 40 times greater detail.
プンプンなのです。
だから実質上のプロローグの位置づけなんだって。
Imagine going through this for the first time and learning that it's a prologue. What?
そのプロローグがこんな凄まじいバッドエンドでございますの?
Well, shit, I guess we're gonna have to go to the next chapter and find out how that makes any sense.
でもそういうのってあるじゃん。この最悪のバッドエンドを回避するためにプレイヤーさんが物語を模索していくのがこの作品の醍醐味だし。
まだ始まったばかりですよ。僕は次のお話が楽しみなのです。
これからどんな話が待ち受けてるんだろう。レナは聞いてる?
うん。
Wow, that one, I guess that line's not voiced. Rena says, yeah,They said the next chapter will introduce another aspect of the story. What?
他のシナリオにはどんな展開があるんですの?
Strange way of putting it, what does that mean?
今回の鬼隠しでは、ひなみざわで近年起こった連続開始事件が紹介されたでしょ?例えば、みーちゃんのシナリオでは、ひなみざわの古い歴史なんかが紹介されるんだって。
I literally heard her say みーちゃん。
異常事態の連続ですっかり分かんなくなっちゃったけど、お社様のたたりってどういうものなのか。
I'm assuming what Rena was actually saying if you were to directly translate that, because she said that the next chapter is going to talk about Hinamizawa's history, but I'm assuming it's going to focus on the Sonozaki family line, since she clearly said Michan, and, well, I know what the second arc is about, and it definitely does focus on the Sonozakis more, so yay for that. And Mion is over here getting lost about Oyashiro-sama's curse. Man, you've got no freaking idea. When I watched Higurashi for the first time in full, it was with Aki, and both of us had a great time not knowing what the fuck was going on. Aki was over there thinking that it like, I had this, if I remember correctly, I had this aspect of, and I'm not, like, just straight up spoiling stuff here. This is completely what my thought process was originally. But I was under the impression that, oh, maybe it is supernatural, maybe it's not. Maybe they're making it too obvious that it's supernatural because it's actually not. And Aki kept thinking the opposite. She kept thinking that it wasn't supernatural, but then because the show kept showing us that there is this curse and things seem to be, you know, a bit spooky and a bit weird and a bit unnatural, that, oh yeah, Shirasama's curse is real and that is what the show is about, and that the show is about an actual curse and not actually about anything, you know, physical or tantamount that you could actually say is, you know, real, is supposedly. So that was just one of the many things that I think was fun about Higurashi the first time around.
Yeah, そもそもお社様って何なのかあまり説明なかったからね。
Well, I thought they explained plenty about what Oyashiro-sama is supposed to be.
よくは聞いてないんだけど、でも、なんか嫌な予感。またしてもたたられそうな嫌な物語です。
Great, thanks, Rika.
ケイちゃんも大変だね。今度はどんなたたりにやられるやら。
でも、どんなお話になるのか楽しみでございますわね。
You're too young to be reading these stories, Satoko.
いやいやいやいや、遅れてすみませんね。
やあみんな。
あ、oh, it's Tomotake。
お疲れ様。
お疲れ。あれ、ケイちゃんは？
ケイジ君はもう次のシナリオの台本読みに行っちゃってるんだよ。
Reading the script for the next chapter。
主人公だから大変だね。
Alright, I understand that these are the actors and not actually the characters, but they're doing it in character, which I think is kind of cute.
残念ですね。ちょっとだけでも顔を出してくれればよかったのに。きっと喋るワード数が多すぎて居残りなのです。
He doesn't have any character art. Oh, he doesn't! Holy shit, he really doesn't, because...I never realized Keiichi never appears, does he, in this entire volume? He's, because you are Keiichi, or you're viewing the story from his perspective. I never even realized that. Holy shit. Maybe he'll show up at a later date.
前原さんのセリフだけで普通のアドベンチャーゲームなら全員分の量がありますからね。
しかし、ケイチ君やレナちゃんなんか特にだけど、大変なお話だったね。大変も何も、大体バッドエンドでございますわ。
Oh, I'm afraid, Sotoko, you ain't got no idea what the mother of all bad ends are, trust me.
結局、ケイチ君を襲ったのって正体は何なんだろう?
Oh my god, this is awesome, holy shit. I'm kind of sad it's over already.
たたりに見せかけておいて、実は人間の仕業ってのが僕の推理なんだけどね。
Okay, so Tomotaki believes that it's actually the work of people that made it look like a curse. Now, that's a good theory. That is one of the theories that, you know, you could have had in your first viewing.
でも、ケイチは最後に謎の電話をかけてきていましたのです。うん。私もあの電話は変だと思ったね。
あの時点でケイちゃんは犯人は人間だと確信してたはずなのにさ。おかしな電話でしたわよね。なんかお化けに追いかけられてるみたいな。あの電話だけだとやっぱり犯人って人間じゃなくてタタリなのかなって思っちゃうよね。
See, so Tomotake was kind of my experience. Because I was really trying to find reasons to see why it wasn't a curse, and Rena's experience is exactly what Aki's was like originally, seeing that it was a curse. And when you're watching it with somebody like that, where one has one point of view and the other has another, because I think I remember saying in my original video that what the show did was make you come up with all these theories, but then none of the theories are even correct or accurate, or at least entirely accurate. So they all get torn down just to provide entirely new information to formulate new opinions on things and new theories. And it just kept rinse and repeating. It was just such an awesome ride. I fucking wish I could have that again. And I did. I did get to have that with the new Higurashi series. You can do more Higurashi, you know. You can do spin-off Higurashi. What about the Higurashi stuff that's like unique to the books and stuff that don't have an anime or anything? Give me that shit, okay? I haven't read them yet, so I don't actually know anything about what they're about. I just know they exist.
せっかくですから、意見を出してみようじゃありませんか?
I thought we just did, Oishi.
じゃあ、園崎さんから。
私は絶対に人間説。
Okay, Mion believes it was people.
雛見沢の怪しい昔語りかなんかになぞらえて、誰かが起こしてる人為的事件だと思うね。
It's a great way of thinking.
確かに。 毎年お祭りの日になると起こる連続開始事件なんて怪しいもんね。その連続開始っていうのも何かの昔語りの再現なんだよきっと。Whoops.
Don't know what I accidentally clicked there.
私はたたりだと思いましたよ。
Alright, Sotoko thinks it's a curse.
玄関でケイチさんが暴れたシーンとか、ラストの電話のシーンとかを見れば、人間が犯人では説明がつきませんもの。
Oh, this is so awesome. This is really cute. Obviously, the fucking actors are in on this shit, but this is exactly the type of thing that you would be thinking in your first playthrough. That's so awesome.
そういえばそうだよね。とても人間の仕業とは思えないシーンだったし。
And what makes this so fucking awesome is that there is an answer to all of it. It does all end up making sense by the time that it's revealed, of course, when all the answers start coming out. And you just look back and you're like, oh my god. And rewatching it as a series, or in this case, playing it and replaying it, you pick up on details you never would have noticed the first time around because you didn't have those answers. You didn't even have a theory yet. That's what makes it so fucking awesome, even on a second time through the story.
Ow,
my fucking leg.
Okay,
so Tomotake still thinks it's a person who did it.
玄関やラストのシーンは追い詰められたケイチ君の被害意識からの妄想じゃないかって思う。
Ah, he was acting very paranoid, that's true.
難しい言葉を使われても分かりませんわ。
That's because you're like 4 years old.
つまり
怖がりの圭一が見た幻だと言ってるのです。
And fucking Rika over here, who's like 5 years old, acts like she's 100 years old.
じゃあ、あのシーンの正体は、圭一さんの後ろにいた謎の気配は何なんですの？
引っ掛けだよ、引っ掛け。
Oh my god, this sounds like me. When I'm watching a mystery show and I say that they keep putting details in there to throw you off.
Mii-chan, hikkake ってどういう意味？
Tomitake のおじさまが言うようにさ、あのシーンは追い詰められたケイちゃんの被害妄想のシーンなんだよ。それを濃密に書くことで、プレイヤーにたたりだと思わせようとする演出なんだよ。だから引っ掛けってわけ。
それを言われると、でも。
I love that sound she just made. That was awesome.
まあそういう可能性もあるってことだよ。
だとすると、犯人は複数で村ぐるみっていう。劇中の大石さんの推理は正しいのかな？
We've got like 7 more chapters to go through. I think we got a while before we find out if any of this shit's correct.
当の本人の大石さんはどう思いますか？
私ですか？な、悩みますね。
あれ？僕はてっきり大石さんは人間説だと思ってましたけど。
劇中の私は犯人は人間だと断じてますが、人間が犯人だとすると、いろいろ不可解なことが多いんですよ。
例えばどんな？大石刑事さんの推理を聞かせてください。
まず人間が犯人だとすると、絶対に動機が必要なんです。こういうことをして、誰が得をするのかってことなんです。
つまりおじさま、人間が犯人なら連続開始事件を起こすことによって誰かが得をしなくちゃいけないってこと？
He's definitely looking at it like a detective would.
そういうことです。ダム開発の関係者が死ぬうちは利害も感じられましたが、近年の犠牲者はそれとも無縁です。第一、前原さんを殺して誰が得をすると言うんです？
なるほど、そう言われると僕も弱いな。
だってお金とかも取られてはいないんですもの。人間が犯人なわけありませんわ。
Okay, here's Satoko coming out again with the curse aspect. Something I didn't even consider, that nothing was taken.
そうとばかりは限らないんじゃない？さっきみーちゃんが言ったように、何かの昔語りの再現そのものに意味があるんだとしたら、
そういうこと。これは営利殺人じゃないんだよ。きっとこれは村の血塗られた歴史を再現するための何らかの儀式的殺人じゃないかなって思うわけ。
では聞きますですが、それを再現すると誰か得をするのですか？
得をするんじゃなくて、もっと心理的なもの。僕は何かの復讐じゃないかと思うね。土着的な何か。今回のシナリオでは語られなかった因縁だよ。
なるほど。過去にひどい扱いを受けた冒険の人たちが先祖の恨みを晴らすためにってな感じですか？私はそれにも反対ですね。
じゃあ何？大石さんはまさかたたり派なわけ？
そうですわ、そうですわ。刑事役の大石さんが言うんですもの。たたりに決まってますわ。
劇中で前原さんが言うように、お社様が竜宮さんや園崎さんに乗り移って悪さをしているって考えると、一番辻褄が合うんです。残念ながら。
実はレナも大石さんと同じ意見なの。あんなに優しかったレナやミーちゃんが突然おかしくなるなんて、そうじゃなきゃ説明つかないもの。
そこは ミオンの私が言うのも変だけど、やっぱり私なんだと思う。
Ah, now we're starting to suspect certain characters. Man, they're really throwing out a lot of the actual theories that you have when you're doing this.
ミーの話の意味が分かりにくいのですよ。説明が欲しいのです。
ああ、ごめん。つまりさ、これってすっごく残酷な話なんじゃないかって思うんだよ。
え？何、ミーちゃん。それってひょっとして…
突き詰めるとそうなるのかな。僕もちょっと疑ってる。
つまり竜宮さんも園崎さんも実は本当にああいう性格で、引っ越してきたばかりの前原さんを騙している悪魔なのだと、こういうわけですか。
そんなの嫌ですわ。
Oh no, it's her whiny voice.
これは全部たたりの仕業なんですのよ。レナさんもミオさんもみんな優しいいい人がいいのですの。
レナもそうだな。レナやミーちゃんって本当にいい人なんだって思う。きっと劇中で出てきた厳しいシーンは何かに取り憑かれてたんだって思うの。
レナもたたり派か。じゃあたたり派の皆さんにお聞きしますけどさ、たたりが起こるからにはそれなりの理由があるんでしょ。無差別にたたるとは思えないな。そこんとこ説明できるの。
たたりはたたりですもの。人間の考えでは想像もつきませんわ。
Oh, that's an argument between
さとこちゃん、擬人化された神様という存在は結局は人間の生み出した。
Whoa! Tomatake, watch your tongue. You don't want to say that too loud. Some people might hear you.
だからその考え方も人間に理解できるようにできてる。ギリシャ神話の神様を見てごらんよ。
What the fuck are we bringing the Greek pantheon into this now?
泣いたり怒ったり嫉妬したり、とにかく人間的なんだよ。
つまりお社様もまた人間同様に何らかの利害に基づいてたたりをしている。
Yeah, because they were naughty.
変な言い方になっちゃったけど、つまりはそういうこと。
触らぬ神にたたりなしって言いますからね。
I've never heard anyone say that until we read it earlier.
一理あります。
つまりお社様にせよ人間にせよ何か理由があるはずということなのです。
That's a very clever way of saying, of telling the reader that there is an answer to it. Just don't fucking know what it is yet.
でもリカ、その理由がはっきりしないならどうなりますの？
Then you keep reading.
つまりは、わかんないということなのです。
Of course you don't, Rika. You're small and innocent.One of the only two innocent characters in the game.
そうだね。まだプロローグだもんね。明かされていないことがたくさんあるだろうし。
そうだね。
It's a great way to itch your nuts and get you to play more.
現時点ではこれ以上の推理は難しいね。
いんにゃ。白黒つけないと納得できないな。
Then you're gonna have to keep reading.
ミオンさんもこだわりますのね。
限られた状況で最大限に推理する。ちょっぴり部活感覚で面白いでしょ。
あ、うん。そう考えれば面白いかも。
じゃあ整理してみましょうか。
What the hell is this music? This must have been from way earlier in the game, when the game was a much more upbeat story.
私はたたり派です。富武さんは人間派でしたよね。
I like how Oishi of all people thinks it was a curse. At least his, not the actual character. Be the last person to expect that.
僕は人間が犯人ってことでいきます。
私も人間犯人説。もちろんたたりというファンタジーは嫌いじゃないよ。だけど。 今回の事件に限ってはたたりの線は薄いね。
人間派が2人出ましたね。リュグさんはたたり派でしたよね。
はい、レナとサトコちゃんはたたり派ですね。
ええ、たたり派ですわよ。レナさんやミオンさんのことを悪魔みたいに言う人の方がよっぽどたたりに合うべきですの。
そりゃあまあ、私も自分のキャラがそんな悪魔みたいなやつだとは思いたくないけどさ。部活モードの時にはクールでなきゃ。感情論だけで選ぶと大やけどするよ。
まあまあ、どっちを選んだっていいじゃないですか。
あれ、リカちゃんがまだだね。どっちだと思う？僕はお社様が悪い神様だとは思わないですよ。
あれ、面白い意見だね。
Wow, here comes fucking little shit over here with a completely different outlook than everyone else, just to make things even more confusing.
当たってばかりの悪い神様なら祀るのは嫌なのです。
Yeah, it's a good point.
僕はたたるよりご利益のある神様の方が好きなのですよ。そっか、リカちゃんって巫女さんをやってるんだよね。うん、いい意見。
じゃあ何？リカちゃんはお社様じゃないって思うなら、やっぱ犯人は人間って思うわけ？
そういうことにしますのです。
ありゃまあ、今日がざっくり分かれましたね。たたり派と人間派で半々ですか。
Rena-chan, just for reference, what did the test players who played the beta version think? The beta version? Yeah. There were a lot more players who believed in the people explanation. See, right there! Our veteran comrades are cool, collected, and very observant. But the beta version only finished partway through the story. That's right. Even the people who played the beta might change their minds if they got through to the very end.
どうすんのさ。これじゃ意見は半々。決着がつかなくて面白くないよね。
裁判官が奇数なのはつまりそういうことだからね。あと一人意見が欲しいな。
Who else is there? There's Takano. There's the teacher. Keiichi's parents.They don't actually show up, do they? They don't have art.
ならちょうどいいかな。ケイチ君本人に聞いてみない？
Why don't fuck Keiichi?
電話で。
Oh, I didn't think about a phone.
たたり殺された本人の意見は貴重ですよ。
そうと決まれば早速電話ですわ。
もしもし、ケイチ君、レナです。今お仕事お忙しいですか？
ああ、忙しいぞ。シナリオが一本終わって一休みって思ってたらすぐに次のシナリオだもんな。
Keiichi, why are you in the next chapter? You died.
ケイちゃん、どんな感じ？忙しいって？
うん、拗ねてる。
聞こえてるぞ、こら。お前ら打ち上げ会でいいよな。俺も出たかった。
収録の残りゼリフ数で僕たちの誰か一人でも抜いたらケイチも参加できるのですよ。
リカ、あの量でそれは不可能ですわ。
あ、それでごめんね、ケイチ君。今回のシナリオでね、ケイチ君、その死んじゃったじゃない。犯人は誰だろうねってそういう話をしてるの。
つまりさ、ケイちゃんを殺したのは人間かお社様のたたりかってことで意見が分かれちゃってるのよ。
本当にごめんね。台本読みで忙しいところ。ケイチ君はどっちだと思うかな。
そんなの決まってんじゃないか。
どっち？
どっちなんてもんじゃねえよ。
What the fuck, Keiichi? Yeah, this music just matches exactly.
村の怪しげな奴らに狙われて、さらにお社様とかいう怪しいのにたたられて。
So he's saying it's both natural and supernatural.
人間もたたりも全部 これは何かの嫌がらせか。
かわいそかわいそです。今度頭をなでなでしてあげますですよ。
It's like the greatest honor you could ever earn is having your head pat by Rika.
結局意見が分かれちゃったね。
私ももう一度考え直してみます。見落としがあるかもしれませんので。
それでは引き続き日暮らしの泣く頃に水をお楽しみくださいね。
わたながし、but we already did わたながし。Another achievement, Onikakushi Party. Actually, I think that means, yeah, I've got all achievements for the game now. How badass is that? Awesome. It's been a long time since I completed a game. Okay, and that is everything in Higurashi Onikakushi, the first chapter to the visual novels. I'm not actually sure if that after party thing, if that was added, like, with re-releases of the game, or if that was actually in the original version of the game. I'm not sure. Either way, that was kind of cool. Because even though they were in character, and obviously they know, I'm assuming, the rest of the scripts. Unless that was genuine, first time actors not knowing how the story goes, I would doubt it, because I don't think the original had voice acting, did it? Pretty sure voice acting just became a thing after Studio Dean's interpretation or adaptation of the story, rather. But yeah, I guess that brings us to the end. That was awesome. I know there was a big gap, and I apologize again about that. If we continue on, I'll try my hardest not to let a big gap like that occur again. Especially with the fact that we were pretty close to the end there. I could have just had the game finished back then. But in regards to how I felt about this, this was a great, great reintroduction into Higurashi. I'm not really sure how much is different with this mod that apparently adds or has access to new scenes and dialogue and stuff, but I can certainly say that compared to the anime, which is great in its own right because you get to see it animated, obviously, but compared to the anime, this is probably way, way deeper and more descriptive, because certain scenes from the anime that are over in minutes or over in a single episode, you know, and then never really touched on again, in this can take fucking 30 minutes to get through, with tons and tons of insight into how what Keiichi's mind was going through, which is not really something you get in the anime. Sure, you get to see how he acts and grows paranoid and starts, you know, suspecting everyone and seeing how he reacts to that, but you don't really get a look inside of his brain, not to the depths and levels that you get in the game here. So that was certainly interesting, and that makes me super curious of how things are going to look in the later chapters of Higurashi here. So I'm definitely looking forward to seeing more of the story later. With all of that out of the way, I guess, yeah, this was a great experience, and I look forward to doing more. Is there anything else that I'm thinking? I suppose I don't know how Higurashi came to be originally, you know, like when Ryukishi decided that he wanted to write this story and make this game. I don't know if it started out in a notebook originally and he was just writing down a story or something, and then he decided to turn it into a visual novel. I don't know how that all came to be. All I know is it ended up coming to be. But the fact that this man came up with this shit in his brain, it's both amazing, it's also quite inspiring, that you can come up with such an intricate story like this. I'm assuming he did it all on his own, but I don't know if he had any help writing the story from other people. I'm assuming this was all just his own project that he worked on in his little computer in his room, and this is what came out of it. Obviously, we have updated visuals and stuff, and, you know, back then you had his own artwork and pictures that were used for the backgrounds and all that kind of stuff, but still, the story came from his brain. The game came from his brain. And the fact that he was able to do that is why he's really high on my analyst staff list, because there really isn't anything else like Higurashi, in my opinion, at least that I've seen or read or anything. I mean, yeah, you could argue, oh, there's, you know, mystery shows and mystery stories and some horror stories, but none of it just comes together like Higurashi does. None of it really has that huge, deep-ass story like Higurashi that you work your way through, uncover the mystery with seeds that are planted early on that you can pick up on yourself before things are revealed through theorizing, and how it all comes together at the very end. Nothing else is exactly like that in Higurashi for me. I mean, there are stories like Attack on Titan has a pretty deep backstory and mystery element that gets revealed over time, but it's not the same feeling that Higurashi has, because I think Higurashi feels a little bit more personal, because Hinamizawa is such a small village, the cast of characters is relatively small and dedicated to one another, so you spend a lot of time with these characters, and each arc kind of focuses on one of those characters. And thus, you get to really know these characters, and you get to really follow along with them as the story progresses, at least as far as you know, the anime is concerned. And that's the anime. And the anime is over in fucking half the time the visual novel of one chapter is. I mean, this took me, I don't know, maybe 10 hours to do, maybe a little over 10 hours. I'm not sure exactly how long it took me to get through this. Steam says I have 19 hours total in the game, and I've played 7 hours. You know what? It's 7 hours in the past 2 weeks. That's 7 hours that we've been doing the past few episodes, I guess, roughly. Didn't feel like that. Not at all. I didn't feel like it was dragging on at any point. I never felt... I would look over at my recording software. Like right now, it says we're up to 51 minutes in this video. I had no freaking idea that 30 minutes had passed, 40 minutes had passed. That's a really good sign, especially for a visual novel, because visual novels that are really static, especially ones that don't really have you involved in making choices and stuff, you have to keep the reader involved and keep their attention on you. Otherwise, they're going to be getting distracted with other things. They're going to feel like it's dragging on, and I never felt like that here. So, fucking amazing, right? And the fact that it took... I guess maybe upwards of 15 hours, because I know that I had loaded up the game in the past. But I don't know, I guess maybe 10 to 15 hours it took us to get through this, right? That's 10 to 15 hours. It's 10 hours to get through the first season of Higurashi, the anime, and that covers like 5 fucking chapters of the visual novel or some shit, right? Maybe a little bit, maybe less than that, but... It definitely does. The fact that you get so much more out of the visual novel. I mean, I always knew people that talk about Higurashi and they talk about, oh, should you read the manga? Should you watch the anime? Should you read the visual novel? Most people say that while they are all pretty good ways to get into the series, everyone says that the visual novel is like the best way to experience Higurashi. And you just wouldn't guess that. And it's especially hard to describe a visual novel to somebody because it's static. It's very static, you know. It's like reading a book, but you get some images to go along with it. You get some dialogue, you know, that gets to be voiced per character, so you feel like you're actually there in the plot. But it's not animated like an anime. That might be difficult for people to enjoy then. But an anime just does not replicate the amount of detail you get in this one volume of the visual novel alone, which I think is why I'm really, really excited to see where this goes. But with that being said, guys, I think that's it here for this one. When I get around to the next chapter, I don't know, but it looks like things are going to be pretty interesting story-wise. Obviously, I know where this is going, but so far we have the idea that the next volume is going to give us more insight on the story, But the fact that Keiichi apparently will be making an appearance in the next game does add a little bit of head-scratching, because apparently he died in this volume. So how the hell is he there? And what is he there to do? Maybe it's a flashback. Maybe it's just a different perspective on the story that already occurred in the first volume. I don't know. Actually, I do know. But those are questions that you might be asking if you're coming through this for the first time. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching and enjoying this. I had quite a few people that were following along, even people that have been waiting that full year that I haven't been uploading this, waiting for it to come back. Hopefully you enjoyed. I definitely enjoyed it, and I look forward to doing more. So see you guys in the next Higurashi video.